Hello, I'm Dr. Ron Eglin, and welcome to Daytona State College. I'm going to talk to you today a little bit about the Bachelor of Science of Engineering Technology and the Bachelor of Science of Information Technology programs. So, first thing we're going to talk about is getting into the program. Well, this is a 2+2 program, and for those of you not familiar with 2+2 programs, it means that it's open admission. If you have an AA degree or an AS degree, you can get into the program. We also have another way to get into the program, which is actually on credit hours. If you've got over 60 credit hours and you've taken college algebra, you can get into the program. But the best and easiest route to get into the program is through the AS or AA route. Now, one of the questions you get all the time, that I get all the time about this program is, okay, well, it is a 2+2, so it's the final 2 years of your program. What do I need to take before I get into the program? Well, looking at this, obviously the mathematics, because it's an engineering tech and an information technology degree, the mathematics is important. So college algebra would definitely be a good start for getting into it. Another thing that's really good to have as a prerequisite, especially in the BSIT program, is some C or Java programming. And we do offer programming sequences here at Daytona State College that would get you through C or Java programming. The other portion of this is the general education program. For those students who've taken an AA degree program, okay, the general education program is that 36 hours of courses in the mathematics, the English, the behavioral sciences, and all those other things that make up that general ed. And you can get information on the general ed program with the AA guidelines. So, if you've got those and you're coming into the program, let's talk a little bit about the program itself. It's actually made up of three components. The first component that we'll talk about is the upper level coursework. All the upper level programs consist of primarily 48 hours of technical coursework. It's usually divided up into two pieces, your required coursework and your elective coursework. Each individual program has different courses that make up both the required or the elective. But what we try to do here is make sure that the programs are flexible enough that we can work with transfer students that may be coming in with credit hours from an engineering or other type of program. Also, there's the lower level coursework. Okay, in the lower level coursework, it's really part of two parts of the lower level coursework. One is the general education program, which is the 36 hours of courses that are very broad. And the other portion of this is the technical lower level electives. The lower level electives are 44 hours of technical coursework that is done at the lower level. Do realize that upper level courses, if you take in excess of 48 hours of upper level coursework, that extra coursework is going to be applied to your lower level technical coursework. And this is going to be the portion of if you have an AS degree from a technical major, you're going to probably have completed the 44 hours of lower level technical coursework. All those extra math that you take in the computer programming, if they're taken at the lower level, will also count towards this. Now, because the mathematics is one of the most important portions of the program, let's talk a little bit about this math. The math for all the programs runs from college algebra through calculus and also includes statistics. So a typical course sequence would be college algebra, trigonometry, pre-calculus, and calculus. In the BSIT, there's also another math, which would be discrete analysis or discrete mathematics, which is part of the BSIT program. In the BSET program, you would also take a course like problem analysis, or potentially you could take calculus 2, or even take your mathematics sequence up through differential equations. Okay, but all of the programs require math through calculus, and then they branch off in different directions. So, if this looks like it's something for you, how do you apply? Well, the application is done at the daytonastate.edu website. It's relatively straightforward, daytonastate.edu. And what we need to do when you're applying for here is get your information, but most important, we need to get your transcripts from the schools that you've gone to, because the transcripts need to be analyzed to determine what's going to be applied to the program. And once you have those analyzed and applied, you're going to get a degree audit, which tells you what have you taken, what are we counting, and what do you still need to take to be able to work your way through the degree. Okay, so that's most important, that you go through the application, but very important that you don't waste any time in getting your transcripts to us, for analysis. Last thing to talk to you about is the fact that this is a fully online program. The 48 hours of upper-level technical coursework can all be completed at Daytona State, all completed completely online. Now, if you have prerequisite courses or lower-level courses that you want to take for this, some of those may be offered online and some of them may not be offered online at Daytona State. However, these courses can be taken at any state college and can come from also the Florida Virtual College, which is another place to get this coursework. So hopefully you'll be able to very easily find the courses you need online for those students that need to be able 100% online and be able to work your way through your bachelor's degree here at Daytona State College. Thank you very much, and we're hoping that this answered a lot of your questions about how the BSET and the BSIT programs work. Thanks.